founder of the Welcome Dinner Project.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. It's lovely to have projects like the Welcome Dinner included in this conversation. As I begin, I'd just like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land, the Gadigal people, and for the care that they've taken of this land for thousands and thousands of years and that we enjoy here today. The Welcome Dinner Project began 4.5 years ago with a dinner in my home in the Inner West in Marrickville, and it was an occasion where there were many familiar faces but also quite a few strangers coming through my front door. And what I saw that night was people's eyes shining. And what I felt was, can only be described really as that feeling of deep connection. And I knew that this was something that had to continue. And here we are 4.5 years later, having had over 270 welcome dinners in every state and territory in Australia, and also the model being picked up in several other countries so far. And what we're really noticing is that there's something about the presence of international students in these dinners that really makes it what they are. And I want to share a little bit about that today. So the Welcome Dinner Project is a social movement. We say we are not a service provider, although it certainly is of service to students. It is something that is driven by the community because it's picking up on something that is most widely and deeply felt in our community. And when we look at what the need it's meeting for international students, that need for connection and belonging, actually it's meeting that for everybody. So half the people at each dinner are local Australians, and half the people at each dinner are new to Australia. So they could be students, international students, skilled migrants, refugees, people seeking asylum, anybody who's new, we group together as new, and then everybody else. And we say up to 5 or 10 years being in Australia can be new, and we let people decide that for themselves. And really this concept came from hearing from people that who are new here, that no one's invited me into their home. I've been here for 5 years, 10 years, I'd love to go to an Australian home, but no one's ever invited me. And actually on that very same day I heard that story from those Sudanese women. I heard from some of my colleagues in a leadership program I was partaking in, can you invite us to meet some of these new people who you work with, because we've been looking for about 10 years to welcome them and we don't know where to go. And the other guy said, oh, you know, I'm just worried about doing something inappropriate, you know, in terms of culturally. So here we have all this goodwill but no platform for people to meet in one of the most culturally diverse cities in the world. So, of course, the idea of connecting around food is a bit of a no-brainer. And so it's really flowed from there. And the story's not over. It's really still unfolding. And the potential is enormous. And so we've heard from students, in one of the very first dinners, she turned to me and she said, when the host was there greeting me at the door when I was walking down the footpath, it felt like my own father was greeting me at the door. This was an international student, and I no longer felt homesick. So simple, but there it is. And about 5 years ago, I heard at a conference a quote, and please, if you know what the source of it, let me know, because I've been looking for the source of it, that over 90% of international students go back to their countries never having entered an Australian home. And so this is also really building the impetus for this project. But not only that, our main outcome that we're seeing is the building of confidence. And we cannot underestimate that, because what comes with confidence from coming to these dinners and, you know, practicing your English is one thing, and it's great for that. But the way that these dinners are designed using the Theory U social technology is for full inclusion, to bring out everybody's strengths, to crowdsource cultural connection and understanding, so that everybody's bringing a dish from their culture. We say this is the opposite of a soup kitchen. No one's being served here. We serve each other. Everybody tells a story. Whether you're a shy person or not, your voice is heard. Everybody's fascinated with your food, and you get to try food from all over the world, being in this beautiful city here in Sydney. We celebrate your culture. We ask, how do you say this dish in your language? How do you say your name? How do we pronounce it? Simple things. We ask about your passion. In fact, the moment when you walk in the door, you write your passion on your name tag. So these very subtle things actually help us embrace this diversity and really build that sense of confidence, but also a sense of well-being. Because people, we hear this time and time again, a student here recently said, you know, it's the first time I felt really listened to in my whole life. So these simple things through storytelling and listening and inclusion and everyone having to contribute actually does help to build the well-being in very subtle but beautiful ways. And of course we encourage people and we provide space at the end of the dinner to exchange contacts and talk about what they could do next, because we want to see those friendships unfold. We want to see the ripple effect in our community. It isn't just a dinner, and we are not an event company. We are about social change. And so we do encourage that, but sometimes it doesn't happen. But what we do see happen most of the time is that building of confidence, which leads to so many things for students' well-being. And so we've been working on a prototype with two universities here in Sydney, and also with some of the English colleges, with the University of Newcastle Global and with UTS Community Connections. And we'd love to share more about that if you're interested in your campus partnering with us. We desperately need funds because we need to employ people. We have such a long waiting list, and as you can imagine, being a not-for-profit, always struggling in that area, and yet there is so much potential here and so much to offer and so much interest, and we'd love to meet that. So love to talk to you. We have our International Student Engagement Coordinators here today, Natalie and Yara, and they'd love to talk to you as well. But one of the things I want to say before I finish is to acknowledge the international students themselves. And Nikhil's going to share some of his story, and also the organisations that we've been working with who have built this and who have the courage to come and partake and to share this with others, and that's how it's really grown.
Thank you, Penny.